The Push-to-Web API. Let's have a look at the Push-to-Web API. You will need to be logged in with your Hugging Face account, which you can do by executing this first cell or by typing Hugging Face -CLI login in a terminal. Just enter your username and password, then click Login. This will store an authentication token in the cache of the machine you're using. Now, let's launch a fine-tuning of a BERT model on the Glue Collab dataset. We won't go over the fine-tuning code because you can find it in any Transformers tutorial or by looking at the videos linked below. What interests us here is how we can leverage the model hub during training. This is done with the push-to-hub equal true argument passed in your training arguments. This will automatically upload your model to the hub each time it is saved, so every epoch in our case. This allows you to resume training from a different machine if the current one gets interrupted. The model will be uploaded in your namespace with the name of the output directory you picked by default. You can choose another name by passing it to the upModelID argument. You can also push inside an organization you are a member of by passing a full repository name with the name of the organization / the ModelID you want to pick. With that done, we can just launch training and wait a little bit. I'll cut the waiting time from the video. Note that the model is pushed asynchronously, meaning that the training continues while your model is uploaded to the hub. When your first commit is finished, you can go inspect your model on the hub by looking inside your namespace, and you'll find it at the very top. You can even start playing with its inference widget while it's continuing the training. The colab dataset tasks the model with determining if a sentence is grammatically correct or not. So we pick an example of incorrect sentence to test it. Note that it will take a bit of time to load your model inside the inference API the first time you try to use it. We'll cut that time from the video. There is something wrong with the labels, but we'll fix it later in this video. Once your training is finished, you should do one last push with the trainer.pushToWeb method. This is for two reasons. First, this will make sure you're uploading the final version of your model, if you didn't already. For instance, if you used the save every n step strategy instead of every epoch. Second, this will draft a model card that will be the landing page of your model repo. Once the commit is done, let's go back on our model page and refresh. We can see the draft of the model card, which includes information on which pre-trained model we fine-tuned, the final evaluation loss and metric, the training hyperparameter used, the intermediate training results, and the framework versions we used so that other people can easily reproduce our results. On top of all that information, the trainer also included some metadata that is interpreted by the Hugging Face website in the model card. You get the value of the metrics reported in a nice widget, as well as a link to a leaderboard with paper with code. The TensorBoard runs have also been pushed to this repo, and we can look at them directly from the model hub by clicking on the Training Metrics submenu. If you were not using the Trainer API to fine-tune your model, you can use the Push-to-Hub method on the model and tokenizer directly. We'll use this to fix our labels in the inference widget. The inference widget was using default names for labels because we did not indicate the correspondence between integers and label names. We can fix this in the configuration by setting the label to ID and ID to label fields to their proper values, then pushing the model config to the hub. Once this is done, we can check on the website and the model is now showing the proper label. Now that the model is on the hub, we can use it from anywhere as we would any other transformer model, with the from pretrain method or with the pipeline function. We just have to use the identifier from the hub, and we can see that the model configuration and weights, as well as the tokenizer files, are automatically downloaded. Try the Push-to-Hub API on your next training to easily share your model with the rest of the world.